Folks, got an interesting story for you today. About a year ago, we went to visit Katriel while she was in the Netherlands. While we were there, we met a viewer. His name is Eric Jansen. He's a longtime subscriber and commenter on our videos. He took us to visit a couple of local dairies there in the Netherlands. Now, the dairy industry is having a challenge in the Netherlands specifically due to some new government regulations which limit the amount of phosphates they can put back on their property. This limits the amount of manure they can generate, and it limits the therefore the number of cows that they can have on the property. Hopefully the number of cats is not limited more than just a couple. Anyway, although I think a couple may be about one too many most of the time. The farms just have to find a way economically to adjust. They were already struggling, and now is even worse because they're limited on the number of cows they can have. In this example, Ronald is taking an approach where he's trying to do some value add. So no longer does he sell just milk. He sells some other products too. Well, I'll not go into any more detail. I'll just let you see for yourself.
We have a different farm than all other farms because we are, for Dutch understanding, we are relatively small. So we have 70 cows and 30 heifers, so younger cows. But we have in about 45 hectares of land for those cows, so it's rather extensive. Mm-hmm. So all the feed for the cows is coming from our own land. Mission of our company is to create as much added value of the products of our animals. So we don't necessarily want to be the biggest, but we want to stay small and have a lot of attention for the animals, mm-hmm. and for the people who work here, so we can create an environment that's like my heart. My company is my heart. Mm-hmm. Here we have the tank, the buffer tank with milk. Once time in 3 days, somebody from Campina comes to empty it. And then the milk goes to Steenderen. It's about 8 kilometers from here.
You just passed it.
Okay. There they make cheese of the milk that comes from here. We have Holstein Friesian cows, this red Holstein Friesian cows. It's a mix. MRI. And MRI is from the old days Maas-Rhein-IJssel cattle, a crossing between Holstein Friesian and Maas-Rhein-IJssel. And for 7 years ago, I started crossing with Montbéliarder. They're from the Jura in France.
Okay.
And they are dual purpose. So they're for milk and they're for giving a good meat quality. We try to age our cows. So they leave when they are sometimes 5 years, sometimes seven, and sometimes 10 years. But when they go, we fatten them. When we think that some cows should leave, we don't put them on the trailer and they go to the slaughterhouse. No, they stay here, they fatten. They leave to a slaughterhouse we choose, and the meat is coming back to us. And we sell it to other restaurants where chefs can work with it. For a long time, people said that meat from cows from 8-10 years, milking cows, was inferior. When you fatten the cow, you create beautiful meat.
So you find that meat from an 8 or 10 year old cow can be just as good and just as marbled in there as
even better, because it's getting time to age. We have chefs working with our meat. That's insane.
Yeah. Wow.
So it's a whole other perspective to look at a farm. The footprint of our meat is the half of cattle beef, because the cow also delivered 40, 50,000 liters of milk in her life.
Wow.
And 400 kilos of meat. And not only 400 kilos meat in 2 years. Beef of milk cows is very good for the world. We make about 150 different kind of ice cream.
Wow.
Flavors. We are very close to our chefs from the restaurants. We communicate a lot, so we get a better product. That's very nice to make a product that's very wanted.
So where did you get the idea of keeping dairy cows and fattening them?
I was born here, and my great-great-grandfather started here in 1921. I have a very strong feeling for this place.
Mm-hmm.
My father and mother, they had cows and pigs. I wanted only milking cows. My dream was to communicate about it and make a product of the milk. I wanted to make a difference. There is a lot of taste in milk and different tastes, but you don't taste it because it's going all to a factory.
Right.
And it's a standard. But with ice cream, you can give it your own flavor. After they are being milked, they come here. And this one needs to calf in a few days. She's stubborn also. She's the only cow at our barn that throws. She throws with food over her. There's always food on her back.
Oh.
And now, because she's going in here, we thought after a few days there was a lot of food on the. So we thought. We put her a rope with her, and now when she tries to throw, she smashes the thing for her head.
That should teach her.
4 hours over.
Oh, wow.
So now it's over, and we hope that she reminds now that she doesn't have to do it anymore. But like I said, she's stubborn, and it is a woman. So the 1st of April till the last of September, half October, they go outside 6-7 hours a day.
Okay.
But the rest of the year and the rest of the days, they're inside. So they have to have a lot of room. One is the strongest, and there's always, there are a few, there are the lower in rank. They have always more ways to get from laying to eating. Because if you have only one way they can go, and the bigger one is standing in front of you, you say bye, I go lie a little longer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And they don't eat. This feed, they eat 6 to 8 times a day. They go to the feed and they eat, and afterwards they lie, or they drink and they lie. And then they burp the feed. Mm-hmm. Up, and they chew. So lying cows, 80 till 85% have to chew. So that's for me a good signal, so that I know that they're doing good. Now the average of the couple of the herd is about 31 liters a day, the
wow.
average.
Mm-hmm.
And the best producing cows produce now 55 liters a day. These ones are inseminated because we try to do our best at early age from calves. We managed to inseminate these ones at 13 months. For 3 years ago, it still was on 15 months, and a cow gave a calf for the first time at 24 months. But these ones will calf at an age of 22 months, because we do our best at the first half year.
Mm-hmm.
And we really do better than 5 years ago. We can shorten the time, because they have the body to, the development is going much stronger, so you have to inseminate earlier.
Mm-hmm.
for a week they were together because it was chilly, so they can stay together. But after a while, you want to see how much they drink, how much they eat, like babies. So you have to have, control about it. Now they are apart from each other. So it's a combination of 50% Holstein Friesian and 50% Black Angus. Here are the ones that about 6 weeks of getting a calf. It's relaxed. They get feed that was no calcium in it. They don't need that in this time. It's more filling than feeding. Now, because they only have to, only the calf has to grow now. They use their energy for the calf. They don't have to give milk. We think this one has 26. She has two calves. You're standing in front of her. She's very
high load.
So we think there's also two in her.
Katriel, I think Ronald has shown us a lot of interesting things here at this dairy.
Yeah, for sure. These cows seem to be the cream of the crop.
That's not even fair.
It was a dairy good pun. You better believe I got more of those.
Oh my goodness.
I even understand them.
Well, before Katriel gets too involved in that, we probably better close this video. And Ronald, we really thank you for showing us around.
Yeah.
And Eric and Enrique.
Yeah.
Enrique. We thank you for the tour we've had today. It's really been wonderful.
It's been unbelievable.
And we'll see you next time on Tractor Time with Tim.